Hardcore, stop this evil before it's too late. Inhumanoids.
Deep within the Big Sur National Forest, scientists today are transporting what many believe to be the skeleton of a long-extinct dinosaur, miraculously preserved in an amber monolith. Dr. Herman Armstrong.
Herc.
Excuse me, Herc Armstrong, leader of the Earth Corps, a government-funded research team dedicated to investigating mysterious events under the Earth's surface. Would you comment on rumors that the monolith was emitting a strange sound and glowing when it was discovered by a pair of campers? And that the trees seem to be speaking?
I'm sure there's a rational explanation for...
Look out!
Signing off from Big Sur, where mysterious events are definitely taking place.
Well, we're down 1 mile, Mr. Shore.
Take the drill down 2 miles.
Oh, but there's nothing down that far.
Yes, there is.
Okay, you're the boss.
Take her down! 2 miles!
Whatever you say! It felt like I just punched through a wall or something!
Whose contributions to our beautiful city of San Francisco are too numerous to mention. Sandra Shore, benefactor of the Shore Museum.
Thank you. Before unveiling this incredible find, let me introduce the brave members of the Earth Corps who will be studying this strange phenomenon. First, Herc Armstrong, leader of the Earth Corps. Next in him is Dr. Derek Bright, designer of the Earth Corps Advanced Technology. Next to Dr. Bright, Auger, distinguished archaeologist and the man responsible for constructing the Earth Corps' specialized suits and vehicles. And finally, Jonathan M. Slattery, better known as Liquidator, master of chemistry, spelunky. Now, without further ado, let us unveil the most significant archaeological discovery of the century.
Weird energy around that thing. That ain't no earthquake. Look! It's crashing the bridge. Yeah. It's not even paying the toll.
Size of the tremors, that thing must weigh about 70 tons.
I'll run the bio tests. According to this, the monster's cold-blooded. Maybe cryogenic. Looks like the vine. I need a tissue sample.
Leave that to me. Auger, don't you?
Well, I'm gonna check out that thing in the ember block.
After the inferno, the monsters simply vanished, leaving behind more questions than answers. Were they from outer space? Mutations caused by toxic waste? Or were they a mass illusion created by the stress of modern living?
Bright, is this part of the weapon or just a doodle?
Amazing. Tissue sample is growing at an incredible rate.
Earth to Dr. Bright.
Hmm? Oh, it's a doodle, I think. File it.
I'll file it.
Hey, look at this, guys. 12th century. Looks like our buddy from last night's been around for a while, huh?
Is that so?
Okay, just thought you might be interested.
These things most likely come from the center of the Earth, General. But we have no evidence that they're extraterrestrials. What do you mean, tell it to the Global Inquirer?
Well, it looks like we're on our own, guys.
Good, I hate red tape.
So, where should we start looking for the creatures?
The way I figure it, they must have escaped into the bay. Let's take the sub and start our search right here.
Auger, the answer lies in the forest. Remember the vibes?
Vibes? Let's be a little more professional, Liquidator.
Well, then let's hear your theory.
All right. An oil worker reported seeing the tendril monster come out of the drilling shaft. That shaft will undoubtedly lead us to the bottom of this mystery.
Well, I'm glad we're in agreement, as usual. Auger, I'll accompany you. Bright, check out the shaft.
Nothing. Nothing at all.
Strange markings. I'm going deeper. Below is amazing. A chamber. It appears to be a cell. I suspect that the tendril monster was imprisoned here.
Sure. They'll need a spatula for him.
That's a terrible tragedy. Trigger the cave-in. Then nobody can prove anything.
Want.
Look, you're
you're right. I couldn't agree with you more. From now on, I won't take so much as a pine cone from this forest.
You are a curious being.
I should have gone for a joyride in the sub with Herc and Auger.
Your aura is good. Your thoughts are pure. Let us show you the horror you have returned to the world. Long ago, a terrible war between the mutors and the evil humanoids raged far ago. The inhumanoid, Metlar, tyrant from the core, decomposed the undead. Along with the peaceful granites, and our magnetic ally, Magneto, fought an impossible war against impossible odds. Though our losses were great, we defeated them and drove them into submission. Was sealed into a stone chamber where he stayed until humans were released. Decomposed was paralyzed by the sunlight and toppled into an amber pit. And the tyrant Metlar was trapped in Magneto's magnetic field. He is still confined, but I fear the others will release him. If that should happen, the world will never know peace.
Don't worry. I promise you we will stop them.
You know, Liquidator's story jibes very well with my own. When I was investigating the drilling shaft, I discovered a deep chamber which might well be this temple's prison.
We must stop the inhumanoids before they can release Metlar. Otherwise...
Too far this time. This was my favorite shirt.
I hope this works.
We've driven it back down. The humor of this situation escapes me.
So did the monster.
Not for long. Earth Corps, suit up. We've got to stop them before they get to Metlar.
I want the Earth Corps' budget cut. Eliminated, Senator. If you can't do it, I'll find someone who can before the next election. Do you understand?
Blackthorn, why do you want to eliminate the Earth Corps?
Look, we agreed you'd handle the glamour and I'd handle the business. Did we not, sister?
What are these? This is our drilling shaft. You deliberately released the monster, didn't you?
It would be in your best interest to forget you ever saw this.
You're insane.
One man's insanity is another man's genius. Their master, Metlar, will soon be my slave. Not only have I unearthed the inhumanoids, but I can control them.
It's a disgrace to be your sister, Blackthorn.
Suits are hardly damaged. My design was flawless.
Your design, but my construction.
We've got a mission ahead of us, and it's a real winner. 1,500 miles below ground is a guy, a thing, called Metlar. He's straight out of a nightmare. If his friends release him, we're ended. There's nothing we can do. Let's get out of here.
Up there! Well, this is as good a place for a last stand as any. Tree roots. The surface is just a few feet away.
So near, yet so far.
If he tries to get up here, we'll nail him.
If only he were that stupid. I think we've dangerously underestimated his intelligence.
Moving.
Redland. Even your mighty people did not fight alone in the last great war. We need your help.
Your machines unleash the Furies. Now your machines must drive them back.
I've never been good with fancy speeches, Commander, so I'll put it to you straight. We're fighting for the survival of Earth. We need more money for digging machines, weapons, and armor.
Forget it, Armstrong. Your budget is cut. Earth Corps is history.
What?
Wasn't I speaking clearly enough? You've been a boondoggle since day one. You're finished. Senator Masterson came down on us like a ton of bricks.
Masterson.
Senator Masterson, a Herc Armstrong is calling. He says it's important.
Tell him I'm out of the country.
Very good, Senator. Now, give me the plans for all the Earth Corps environmental suits and weapons.
Very well, Blackthorn. I guess it doesn't make any difference now.
You've been slamming the phone down a lot lately.
I'd rather be slamming a few heads together. Our funds have been cut. We're out of business.
Well, gentlemen, I'll be seeing you.
Where are you going?
The unemployment office. Anyone care to join me?
Look, Derek, we've still got a job to do. Money isn't everything. Now what do you say we get back to work?
Nice place you got here.
Your next crack will cost you.
That'll be $75.
Anybody got any money?
I got 20.
35.
Gentlemen, save your money.
Sandra, sure?
Keep the change. I'm sure you earned it.
Oh, thanks.
Thank you, Miss Shore. But why are you doing this?
I'm willing to fund your expedition into the Earth.
Hey, fantastic.
But there is a catch. I'm coming with you.
Oh, wait a minute. It won't be...
Those are my terms.
All right. We accept your terms.
This is the Terra Scout. Assuming that Auger knows how to read, it'll be ready when we are. It will hold two scientists. Auger will operate the control panel and front gun, which pivots side to side to ward off inhumanoid attack. And the liquidator will ride a detachable flight pod unit for escape and exploration. This is the trapeur. Kurt will ride in front, operating the claw. The hook can be used for lifting, dragging, tying, or scaling. The trapeur, like the Terra Scout, is equipped with a hover platform.
We're approaching the Mojo Discontinuity.
The what?
The Mojo Discontinuity.
Mojo Discontinuity is a natural barrier that divides the mantle from the Earth's crust.
There's the thing we're talking about.
It must have been a fortress of some kind.
Bats! I hate bats!
Battle position!
Power! All of it's coming down!
fought well.
Augur, your suit's damaged beyond repair. You'll have to return to the surface.
Rubbish!
But your respirator unit is ruined.
Well, if I'd used your design, it would have been. But fortunately, I threw out your design and built this myself.
You're almost through!
I don't believe it.
Earth's mantle. Look at that. Diamonds. Just one of those, and I'll be wealthy for life.
Let's go for it.
Imagined Earth's mantle would be this beautiful. Herc, I'm picking up something.
What?
I don't know, but it sure got a catchy beat.
It's a battle. We're too late.
Nonsense. If it were over, we wouldn't hear it.
The sounds are coming from behind that wall.
That wall's pure crystal. The battering ram won't even scratch it.
I call this instant doorway.
Let's see that giving you a hot foot now!
worry. I'll track them. That must be some sort of secret chamber.
We could use a secret chamber about now.
On your lights.
All right, guys, you can stand up. It's just us.
Who are you creatures?
We want to help.
We're your friends. One can never be too careful in this strange age. Especially when another creature such as yourself seeks an alliance with Metlar.
What are you talking about?
See for yourself!
I have not seen those metal creatures before!
Metal only provides the shell! Surface-dwelling flesh slugs live inside!
Tendril, it will be your duty to shatter them!
Who've ever run away from her.
If she doesn't do something about her looks, he won't be the last.
Car! Save me! Give us one good reason why we should. I possess the secrets of the Inhumanoids! Keep them! Without my knowledge, they'll crush human civilization!
What do you think?
Maybe worth a grenade?
What the heck?
Thanks, suckers!
Now that's gratitude for you.
So, the flesh shrubs fight among themselves.
left our kingdom. I don't know, but I say we anger them no longer. What do you say, folks?
That's the whippiest thing I've ever heard.
Down, Augur. The granites are only...
Yes, but in the long run, look, the Inhumanoids are going to come back and kick their boulders to...
I agree with the flesh slug.
Humans! We're called humans!
Well, I stand corrected. Nevertheless, the humans are right. I move that we forge a real peace and stand against the Inhumanoids now! All opposed?
Make buildings, not war!
The majority clearly favors action, which is your department, General Granitary.
I will begin making logistical and military plans as soon as the Senate determines our military objectives.
I'll give you your military objectives. You find this Metlock character.
It will not be so simple. He cannot be destroyed. Only neutralized by MagnaCore's magnetic field.
And MagnaCore has been captured.
I don't know. Tell me if I'm out of line. I think we must negotiate with Metlar for his release.
Negotiate? This is how you negotiate! Enough, Augur, enough! Granik, one of our party has been decomposed. Is there any way to reverse the process?
Yes, but it will not be easy. The creature must be exposed to Whiteburn.
Whiteburn?
Yes, the force that turns water into air, black into white, cold into warm.
Must be their name for sunlight.
Barring any objections from the worthy Granites, I have a plan. After we repair our vehicles, we'll split into teams. I'll take the Trapur and an assault force of Granites to decompose his lair, Skillwell. Right, I want you to head to the surface and mobilize the Redwoods. I have a gut feeling the Inhumanoids aren't through up there.
Now, over there is what is known as the high watermark of the Confederacy. Hoping to break the Union lines, Lee ordered Pickett's charge right on this very battlefield. The Yanks stopped him, and the war was pretty much over, save for the shouting.
Is that part of the show?
When you think about it, nearly every ancient culture had some kind of vision about the underworld. Maybe it's part of the collective unconscious. Sure makes you wonder, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah. I wonder about that all the time.
Bingo! In mythology, there was always something guarding the underworld. The Russians thought it was a monster named Surma. The Greeks had a dog named Cerberus.
And you hurt me!
Would bring you around.
Which
childishness of your species is exceeded only by your lack of patience.
If humans lived 2,000 years, maybe we wouldn't be in a hurry either.
He has a point.
Quiet, Ritzy. What do you want of us?
We know that Metlar is going to be coming to the surface for energy. Only your people can stop him. Now here's my plan.
Must have pulled this entire town down from the surface of the earth.
I dislike the human's choice of building materials.
I'll make a note of it.
Minions!
to the surface and do not return without the energy I require.
I will not fail.
Failure is not a word I understand.
It would be foolish for the Inhumanoids to attack again.
But according to the human Dr. Bright, Metlar will stop at nothing to obtain the power he needs.
Help! The bone shark's after us! Emergency! Emergency!
Right here, Redson! Describe the emergency! Come in! Come in! What's happening?
Thank you.
right, Sandra. It's the only thing that will...
Save a death, insignificant insect.
Sandra, let's go.
Herc, there are some things I have to tell you.
Are you sure they're the same statues?
Well, to tell you the truth, they do seem somehow changed. Almost as if they is about to...
Charge!
Too many of them! There's no way out!
Do something!
Darn Yankees!
What do you mean, darn Yankees?
Trust them rebels to mess up a good alliance!
To figure that out.
He'll never get the chance! I've studied the Inhumanoids! I know their weaknesses! Observe! A slight shift in the magnetic field and... I'll move him like a puppet!
What do you have to do to make him stop you?
Higher, reverse polarities on the next surge.
Yes, and make a charge above set so that I can concentrate.
Now, all you have to do, Earth Core, is pledge allegiance to me!
Well, you gotta hand it to him. This guy's funny.
Now, tell me how it feels to have your suit squeezed like toothpaste tubes. You're insane, Blackthorn!
My relics are snapping.
Now, reverse polarity.
Choose your death, flesh slug! Divide and repel! Time for this! It's all a tunnel! How far?
you find in the muck nowadays.
Metlar! You were a fool to save me, because you will never again be free of my grasp!
It appears that you have come upon some difficulties, flesh slug. Suppose you were to wriggle free, where would you go? Return to the other flesh slugs who despise you? No, human, your future is with us. Tell us where the flesh slugs keep the ultimate primal energy.
Of course, master.
I don't think it'll keep the rain out, but it's good for a start.
Why would one want to keep rain out?
Obvious, Redlin, so they do not corrode.
Any sign of Auger and Liquidator yet?
Magnacore!
Earth! Sandra! Great to see you!
But your timing could have been better.
We have reported a slight tremor, comrades. Please investigate.
We have observed an underwater object. Shall we identify or launch depth charge?
Launch the depth charge, of course!
We must resist fighting out of emotion.
Right if you're chippy.
Hark on, Strong! It's Senator Masterson! We have a problem!
So do we! Not the least of which
Mr. Blackthorn's with him.
It can't be.
General Craig, I would like you to meet Earth Corps.
How do you do?
Last time I saw you, you were feeding me to the monsters.
I'm sorry, Sandra. That was not my intention.
Gentlemen, allow me to get directly to the point. We need your help. This Metlar's armies have attacked a Soviet weapons depot and stolen enough firepower to seriously damage this planet.
I find that highly unlikely.
If your brain were as quick as your mouth, you'd understand the implications of the two missing cluster missiles. One will shatter the Mojo Wall, and the other will ignite the Primal Core, and thus convert the Earth into a molten slag heap. Funny, that's what I was gonna do to your face.
Hold it, Augur. He might need his teeth for a few more minutes.
We're nearing the Mojo Wall, and I'm still not picking up the missile signals I'd expect.
We will need this Blackthorn's word for where the cluster missiles are. I do not trust him. No need for the handcuffs in here.
We should be able to follow Earth Corps' progress.
Either we reach the wall or before they...
They're almost out of range already.
What time is it, General?
In 30 seconds, it'll be 1,500 hours. What difference does it make?
All the difference in the world, General.
Why, what's happening?
It's an earthquake!
No, Senator. It's a series of explosions designed to crack the Earth's crust. The first cluster missile will detonate the Mojo Wall, but not quite where I told Earth Corps it would be.
Then Earth Corps is heading into a trap.
But of course, General. You see, I haven't been completely honest with you gentlemen. I made a bargain with Metlar. We agreed that I would rule the few islands that would remain after the blast. If I would eliminate the one thing that stood in his way, Earth Corps.
Mars, you are terrible.
Yes, precisely.
At least we made it here before the missiles went off. Now all we have to do is defuse.
It's a fake.
An explosion near the surface of the world. I can feel it in my crystals.
Blackthorn must have set us up. The real missiles are supposed to destroy us all.
Before the last missile takes us out.
It is my belief that Earth Corps is destroyed. So we all hope the flesh slugs will land. Now, all that remains to do is to detonate the Primal Core. First, troops, you must march to safety while decomposed and tendrils.
Missiles.
Where?
Think we made it. Never hatch your chickens before they're counted. I'm getting an unpleasant reading from below.
Job, but someone's got to do it.
What the ride lacked in comfort, it made up for in speed.
Well, we're all still alive, and that counts for something.
All right, let's head them up and move them out. Megagore, power on! That's what I call teamwork.
I find that dam most curious. I wonder what it's for.
Probably to hold back liquid. That's what most dams are for.
Brilliant, Auger. Simply brilliant.
Auger, look! There's the cabin we took to Infernax.
And we're right on target. Just hope we're on time. The dam blew, and the stuff coming out is hydrofluoric acid. Liquid Ender, will our suits protect us from hydrofluoric acid? Not a chance! Nothing can protect us!
Earth Corps! There's a bridge ahead! Wait for it!
Oh, and I thought we were just poking along!
I'd hear myself saying that.
Strike quickly, flesh slugs!
10, 9, 8.
Earth Corps, crush them! 1 down.
5, 2 down.
4, 3. That's 3.
You've got 4.
2, 5.
They fired!
After all we've been through,
we missed by seconds.
Missiles weren't enough.
Of course. He needed all 10.
All he succeeded in doing is dissipating the core's energy.
It's turning cold.
You shall.
on primal energy to begin with.
Let's get out of here before Metlar notices we're still alive.
You betrayed me!
A simple desire to save our own skins.
Do you fear death more than you fear me? Bring me the flesh slug's metal skins!
Earth to Mutors, we're on our way.
We know what to do.
Our energies are aligned.
Originally found it.
Sandra, I must offer you both my congratulations and apologies. I was bullied by Blackthorn and you saved the day. I hope this new headquarters will mend things between us.
Funny how he gives away the taxpayers' money as if it were his own.
We don't know how to thank you, Senator.
Gentlemen, I have always believed that statesmanship would triumph over petty political squabbles and have dedicated my life to spreading that philosophy.
No two ways about it. I've got to mess this place up before I can get back to work.
So, Sandra, what did you say you were doing for dinner?
You're the fourth guy who's asked me that in the last 10 minutes.
Now, where did that tendril sample go?
Who knows? Things got messed around during construction.
Oh, well, I'm sure it'll turn up sooner or later.